This is unique. And if done correctly, the world will see it.
We've never had that place where a big group can come. And this is our chance.
They can't come to Huntsville now. There's not a place big enough for them.
Having a space that's this big to accommodate bigger artists is just like groundbreaking, I think, here.
The city knew they wanted something special and very unique for Huntsville.
Having them build a venue in a high-tech city, you know they're on their top game.
We got to remember, this is a community that said, yes, we can put man on the moon and bring him home alive. It's, I think, natural for us to want to design a facility that's a little bit different than others.
A big part of my job on projects like this is I go in and I try to scare the crap out of everyone about what a nightmare it's going to be. They didn't even blink.
It's really like throwing down the gauntlet.
The premise is we're going to go and build the best venue in the world. What does that really mean?
It looks almost almost Roman Colosseum-like.
You're just in awe of the grandeur and the scale of the place.
Most amphitheaters that have been built recently are pretty flat. This is a building that just doesn't happen to have a roof on it.
You walk out on stage and you'll be just looking at a wall of people.
It's going to be super intimate. It's going to be really vertical. It'll be the kind of place where an artist can stand on the stage and probably without amplification be able to speak to the person in the very top row.
Wait until people start singing along and clapping along. And I think there's going to be some very special moments in this space.
So much of this has come from Ben Lovett's brain.
He's been on hundreds of stages around the world and seen the good and the bad. He's really, really trying to create an experience that's really good for the bands, but it's equally as good, if not better, for the fans who come out.
This is really a venue where every single detail has been thought about. How do we make this the best it could have ever been?
From the second they roll up in their bus and their crew starts to unpack the trucks, they'll be able to tell that every step of what they need to do that day has already been thought of for them.
We really expect it to be the kind of venue that performers really want to come to. So, you know, we get the performer that maybe you wouldn't normally think of coming to Huntsville, Alabama, but there's something about that venue that they want to say they performed there.
I've spent a lot of time over the last 5 years trying to figure out what it is about a venue that makes it special. A really critical part of that, I think, is the food and beverage experience.
We really want to be able to reflect the food, the culture of North Alabama. The era of getting a hot dog and a beer and rushing to go see a show and leaving before the encore, that era needs to end. You know, people need to be enjoying the full concert experience.
The Mid-City has to be an experience. It has to be a place where people come to.
I think Mid-City itself has already captured the spirit of bringing all kinds of people together.
Mid-City represents what we do in revitalizing and redeveloping.
You can live, play, work, but you can spend so much time there.
The area has one of the most incredibly musically rich history of anywhere kind of in the United States with what was happening in Muscle Shoals.
So just being from the South really is just something about special about the music. It's like a different soul with a different vibe.
Muscle Shoals just has like this deep-rooted like history of like greatness.
Right now, there's a great opportunity for people to be taking that heritage and that history and not only amplifying the past, but really writing the future for this whole area. So the fact that it's going to be a world-class amphitheater and have artists from all around the world performing, that people pilgrimage to see, that's a great piece of it. But the idea that any given day of the week, you can go there and you can experience maybe a local music event, a farmer's market, an arts festival. We want this amphitheater to be something that everyone in the area is able to enjoy on any given day.
If we built this and had 18 great concerts a year and all the other days it was locked up, we would have failed.
I think that this is going to be one of those things that people talk about in this little old town from Huntsville, Alabama, that is just special, a place that you've got to get to.
It embraces so much of what a city in the South, what a city in the U.S. could be doing and is doing. And I think to be able to bring people here and show them that, they'll leave inspired.
One of the greatest joys of my career has been working on the Huntsville Amphitheater. I mean, there's so much to come. We are just at the starting line.